So what we need to do here is first select the directory where we want to save the data. So if you look here, you'll see that we have a C drive and a data or D drive. You always want to save your data in the D drive, and you always want to save it in user data. And if you click here, this will expand. You should make if there isn't one, or you should use if there is one, a folder with your first and last name on it. So I'm going to select my folder in user data, say OK. That is where I want to put things. Note that it's actually a good idea, if possible, to select a directory with the date on the particular day that you're doing the experiment, just to organize your files better. So I'm going to go back here. I'm going to expand my folder and just select a subfolder that I had made with today's date. That'll keep your data more organized, and we'll discuss a little bit how your data structure looks later once we've acquired some images. But just take my word for it that it's good to organize it in folders for now. So I'm going to say OK. I want to increment the base name if file exists. You always want this checked, because what this will avoid is overwriting data. So what it'll do is, here we're going to place a base name, and I recommend you keep this short and sweet. Sample is just fine for now. So if you acquire a data set and then you acquire another data set, even if you haven't changed anything, they won't be overwritten and called sample and then sample again. Instead, they'll be called sample, sample one, sample two. And so this really helps keep your data organized. So that's really all we need to worry about within the saving subtab.